What is going on, guys? We are back with more World Cup. We got ABR versus Mazzara, and I've got to switch sides real quick because you know I'm rooting for Germany. This is World Cup round 2, so it's basically quarterfinals. 8 teams are left, and US East is a big favorite versus Team Germany. But we do see Mazzara abroad, interesting team. If Manectric Volt switches on Heat Twin, he can trap it with Dagi, but the thing is, he will never really go on the Heat Twin on Manectric because he has a Quagsire. So Manectric looking kinda useless this matchup. He has to get rid of the Quagsire so Manectric can Volt around, and even then, it's not the biggest threat. He can still check it with Mew and with Heat Twin. So let me look at the teams and everything. I think the score is 0-0. This is obviously Sun and Moon OU, the first game that they are playing. I will show you guys the matchup when the game is over. Like, I'll talk about that at the end. Like, all the teams that are still in World Cup, stuff like that. I think this is Skarvladios. And ABR's Landers is probably Z-Move. Could also be Z-Move Coco. But I'm thinking it's Rocks Landers. So if I'm ABR here, I would probably go into Tapu Koko, depending on the Landris set obviously, but I would not want to let this take a Draco Meteor. He does let it take a Draco Meteor, well, just to U-turn out, okay. I mean, now the Latias is really low, and he can go into Tapu Koko and click U-turn here, right? He goes Toxapex, that's a fine play, yeah, that's fine, he's at minus 2, like. I can calc real quick if ABR's Latios is... If ABR's Landers was offensive. I assume it's gonna get a Toxic Spike or... maybe just a Scald. Toxic Spike only hit like these two Pokemon, so I'm not sure. He might also have regular Toxic. Yeah, I just want to figure out if that's offensive. Offensive Landers. Landers Therian form. Let's Choice Scarf U-turn this. Yeah, I think it's offensive. U-turn does 66 to 78 to Latios. He goes hard into Dugtrio and the T-Spikes. And I assume it's a Z-move Dugtrio. The thing is, this doesn't Oko the Toxapex from full. It's Shed Shell Toxapex. Oh my lord. Well, it's looking bad for Mazzara. He's gonna go for. This might be substitute. We will substitute Screech. I don't know if he would just go for Softbolt here. Yeah, he just goes for Softbolt. Because if he goes for Will-O-Wisp into the Woods Toxic, the thing is he's gonna get poisoned through the substitute. That's how Synchronize works. But yeah, ABR doesn't have Heal Bell or anything to get rid of this status. Yeah, but you have seen, I think this is the third time we see Shed Shell Toxapex used in World Cup. You might have seen it more often, but it's the third time that, at least that I remember, it used. I know that Flame Victini had a team with it that was used twice. Oh, I think Meeps also used it, so this might be the fourth time that we see Toxapex used. Maybe even more often already. So the Magina, it could be either a Solvest. I'm thinking it's a Solvest Magina. It could also be Leftovers with Calm Mind and Shifty, like Double Dance, but I assume it's Assault Vest, like he has no Greninja Switch Imps. Is he just gonna... okay, he spams Knock Off. He decided to go into Landorus, not sure. He just wants to get up his Rocks, I assume, but this Mew might have Ice Beam. Yeah, he has Quagsire, which can also check Zygarde. What is a Quagsire for? I mean, I know it's for setup, but is there a specific setup Pokemon that he's beat to? Like, Bellydrum Azure isn't really used that much. What else? He goes on a Heatran scouting for Ice Beam or predicting a Will-O-Wisp. Nice play by Mazzara. Show me the substitute, Heatran. Show me the substitute. I'm pretty sure that he's... He was Rocks on Landorus. I think this is Subland, though. It could be Z-Move. No, he shot Z-Move. He shot Z-Move Dugtrio already. Yeah, never mind. And what is ABR's? I'm thinking he's Scarvlander, right? Ooh, the Mew's faster, so there go the leftovers. This sucks a lot. But at least the Mew's getting chipped down. If you have Elf Power, you beat the opposing Heatran one-on-one. He's just gonna Magma Storm here, I assume. Elf Power, whew. Hard Elf Power, that did absolutely nothing. He can potentially taunt. Actually, they don't really carry taunt. They carry sub Earth Power, Magma Storm, and Toxic, right? But the Trent losing the leftovers is really annoying. He's fishing for Spadef drops. He gets a crit and a Spadef drop. So there we go. I can see ABR switching here. Ooh, he stays in. And Mazar overpredicts. I mean, I completely understand the Toxic play there. Like, I would have expected a switch potentially too. But he would have lived another Earth Power, so I can also understand ABR's play. In case he wants to overpredict. And now he's gonna Scald, I assume, to break the substitute. Oh man. This is so hard for Team Germany to win versus East, like, overall. Like, there's so many matchups where East is favored. That did nothing, by the way. It goes for Infestation. I don't think that works through the substitute. Oh, this doesn't have Scald. This is the Flame Victini set. It's Toxic Spikes, Recover, Infestation. Toxic is the last move. Ooh, so this cannot break the substitute at all. So he has, like, he has to stall out the Earth Power PP. Okay, so maybe Mirza isn't even in that bad of a position if this can't break the sub. It goes into Quagsire. On a Magma Storm, this is gonna do a lot. So is he gonna go for Toxic? Not sure if ABR wants to recover or break the sub here. I think he just has to break the sub. What moves did Mew show? Did it show Knockoff and Will-O-Wisp? There's the Toxic, there's Recover, and... Dude, imagine this had Heatran at lefties, it would be at full now. It would be so cool. But yeah, you can fish for a Spadef drop. The thing is, he doesn't have Healing Wish or anything to bring his Heatran back if he subs. He misses a Magma Storm. Ah, dang, that sucks. I mean, he did crit Spadef drop the pack, so that's not much I can say. But I would... Like, I would take some hacks in Team Germany's favor. So he's basically subbing down so the poison damage brings this in range from Magma Storm. But this might be a roll. Never mind, the Toxic brings it down. Earth Power kills here. So he's gonna Earth Power here, take out the Quagsire. And then ABR is gonna send out... Maybe the Tapu Koko... Or the Toxapex, not a, I don't know, I don't think he would send out the Toxapex, because that would allow Mazar to get up another substitute. Yeah, I think he would send out his Coco or his land. No, his land was at 12%. Yeah, he could send out his land because he's Choice Scarf, but then he would have to predict. If the Heatran stays in, yeah, exactly, he just sends out the Coco. So this is between U-turn and T-Bolt. We already know that the Ducktree isn't Choice Scarf, so even if he T-Bolts and he goes in the Ducktree, we can just U-turn out on the next turn. Heatran is... The Toxic on the Mew is really nice, though. Like, ABR's team did get weakened a good amount by this Trin. Would he keep this Trin around? Keeping Trin around is nice to have... Like, it can put in some work still versus the... The Toxapex can touch it, so if he doubles this in on the Toxapex, he gets a free sub. Mew can also not break the sub, so... ABR's way of breaking the sub would be... Either with Coco, or with Landris, or with Earth Power from his Heatran. Because I'm pretty sure Knockoff from Mew doesn't break the sub, so I can understand that he saved it. And he just T-bolted here. I'm pretty sure HPS doesn't kill from this range. Maybe Expert Belt killed. So I think we're gonna see a U-turn from ABR into what? This is a tough position. He doesn't have Earthquake switch-ins other than his own Landorus. I can see Mazar going for HBIs predicting the Landorus, but I can also see him just Earthquaking because, like, yeah, he just goes for U-turn like as expected into Landorus. Does he HBIs? He does just Earthquake. It makes a lot of sense because it would have hit everything else other than the Landorus. Oh well. I assume this is gonna be U-turn, Earthquake, HPIs, maybe Stone Edge or Knockoff in the last slot. It could also be Explosion, but I'm pretty sure U-turn, Earthquake, and HPIs is pretty much set into stone on Scarf Landorus, right? This generation at least. Last generation was a different story. I would think about going into Majorna here from Mazar, because I don't think ABR would ever go for Earthquake here, but what do I know? He might just make the play. He just goes for U-turn, which is understandable. I assume Mazar's gonna get up his rocks here. Yeah, now he's probably in range from HBIs. So I would go into Magearna here. In the Magearna on the HBIs. Landorus dies to rocks now, which is nice. I mean, I like my Zar's team, but I'm not the biggest fan of of Manectric. But I'm pretty sure this is like Volt Switch Magearna and Volt Switch this, so do you can bring Inductree on stuff like... Like, on Toxapex might come in on Magearna, so you can Volt Switch on that. Heatran would come in on those two, so you can trap them. Unless they're Shed Shell, which is like seen sometime... Yeah, exactly. Like, Shed Shell is seen sometimes at the moment. But yeah, that was pretty obvious HPIs. He goes into Assault Vest Magearna. Pretty sure that's Assault Vest that did 3. And he goes for Z-Move. Is he Z-Wild Charge? Okay, that is not Z-Wild Charge. Okay, nice. For a second, my heart was like, holy shit, don't do this again. Because Blunder brought Z-Wild Charge with Mazar and just destroyed his Magearna. But from what we've seen, we already saw... Yeah, it's pretty obvious that he's a Special Attack invested Tapu Koko. Because we saw T-Bolt and Hidden Power Eyes. So yeah, this is a Scarf Latios, and I assume it's just gonna click Psyshock if it kills. I'm not sure if Psyshock kills. I'll calculate quick. Lati versus a Tapu Koko. Psyshock does 69 to 82, so it's a roll, and if he has a that's Life Orb, never mind, that's Life Orb. So it doesn't kill then. The 63 max. Does this get something that can kill Tapu Koko? I gotta calc Psychic real quick. Psychic does 66 to 78, so it would be a roll in ABR's favor, heavily in ABR's favor. The thing is, if he goes for Psyshock or Psychic, this is probably in rocks in range from Stealth Rock, so that's nice in the sense that it can't come back in. Also, Germany like brought in, like they subbed in some people. Yeah, he goes for Psyshock, but it's not even in range from Rock, so. Was that a low roll? 53 to 16. No, that was like a high roll. Like, they subbed in some people that haven't played in the last round, and they also made some changes, like X-Ray is playing DPP now. My man Padlop might have. Not sure. Like, I think my man Padlop is busy. He might have played this week if he wasn't busy. This is a rematch, by the way. I think they played last year in finals, East vs Germany, and it was really close. But Germany lost a lot of good players. Like, Germany is still okay, but I don't think they're not anywhere as good as they were last year. Like, set at Cosine quit. Would be so interesting to see if Cosine would also... if Cosine would play still Auras, or if he would play a new gen. But they have get this money for Auras, so... I think Cosine could play Sun and Moon if he was still active. But yeah, he quit. So yeah, Manectric gets the immediate speed boost, so it outspeeds Tapu Koko. Does it? Pretty sure it does outspeed. Yeah, it does outspeed Tapu Koko. I don't know if HPI is killed, but yeah, I think ABR might just sack off his Landorus to rocks here. Yeah, there's no point in clicking anything other than T-Bolt. You just click T-Bolt here if you Mazar. I guess you can click Volt Switch, but T-Bolt just doesn't lose you anything. Like, you get damage on Heatran, you get... You Tweet KO Mew, you kill Tapu Koko, you Toxapex is not a switch in any way, and Landorus dies to Rock, so you don't even have to HP Ice. I wanted to run some Kalk. I forgot which Kalk I wanted to run, if T-Bolt kills Tapu Koko, but I'm pretty sure it does. Yeah, T-Bolt does... Wait, does 51? That doesn't sound right. Oh, it's an Electric Terrain. Does 34. Why does it do so much? He just sacks off the Landorus to the rocks, and now he's gonna go into his Heatran, I assume? I think he's gonna go Heatran and click Magma Storm. This is a tough spot for ABR. Like, he can still win, but... He goes in a Mew. I thought he would go Heatran. What is this gonna do? I think Zara is just gonna Volt Switch into his own Heatran, right? There's no Stealth Rocks up. And he doesn't have any Volt Switch blockers left, so this is nice. So I said Manectric wasn't gonna do anything this game, but he got rid of the two ground types, so he can Volt Switch around freely now. And the speed tier from Manectric is really nice, and ABR's Choice Scarf user is already dead, so like Manectric might clean up late game. Wow. Really nice. Like, usually I would root for ABR, like I like his playstyle a lot, but like I gotta root for Germany. And he gets a crit. Oh, that sucks. I think this game is over. I mean, that obviously sucks, but like... The Toxic would wreck up on the Mew eventually. Like, I don't think it mattered too much, right? Did it matter? Mizar's hidden ability. I think the game was in his favor at this point. Like, Germany needs every win that they can get. I'll show you guys the matchup at the end. Like I said, there's like some... Like, ICT versus John. Like, I saw ICT say before the matchups came out, if he gets John, he will run away. Because, like, John is a beast or an animal or something like that. So he's really scared to play him. I would be scared too. I think this Toxapex might live a T-Bolt because it's really spadef. I can run a Kalk. And he might just go for Skull. Infestation, I mean. Yeah, if it's the defensive set, it probably dies. But if it's like Calm... If it's Calm, it has a really good chance to live. And yeah, it's really spadef. That did nothing. That did 58. So he's forced to Volt Switch out here, right? I mean, he doesn't have Lefty, so he still took 8%. But the T-Swag is wearing this Manectric down. But not that it matters at this point, like... Tapu Koko's at 4%, so... Tapu Koko can technically still win the game. No, it cannot. I mean, if this Manectric would die... I think Tapu Koko could kill everything other than the Midjourna. And the problem is that it can't... If it kills the Ductrio, I think it's... No, it has HP Ice, it doesn't have to U-turn out. So Tapu Koko can still win this if Manectric goes down. And he gets some chip damage on Midjourna, because I'm pretty sure Midjourna takes like 25, 30 maybe? 30 maybe from T-Bolt? I think Mizar would... Is either T-Bolt spamming? Oh, he Volt Switch and gets a crit. Okay, that sucks. Holy shit. Well, this isn't fun anymore. I wanted to see if we find... Like I said, I think Mizar had the game anyway, but this is annoying. Like, Volt Switch would have done like 35 and he could have recovered up. And he would have been pretty healthy, and then... The thing is, he got a Volt Switch into his Heatran, right? And then he just clicked Off Power, he just clicked Substitute. And he spammed Off Power. It's not like Toxapex could break the sub from the Tren. But he's gonna click T-Bolt here. Manectric still being alive wraps this game up for Mizar. So he's gonna go to Manectric or Midjourna here, but I would not go Midjourna and risk getting crit. So he just clicked T-Bolt. Volt Switch is fine too, I guess, because you don't know the Heatran set. But yeah, Coco would have done 34 to 41 with to Majuna with Magnet. That's if the Majuna has no Spidef investment. He Volt Switches out in the Duck Trio and this game is over, unless... I guess he could be Scarftron, but I'm pretty sure that Scarftron... Yeah, it's Protect. Scarftron... Could Scarftron win with Fire Blast? Yeah, Scarftron could actually win this game with Fire Blast, that's crazy. Mizar does pick up the win for Team Germany. I'm happy to see him win, but... The Hex is, sucks, definitely. Like, I want to see clean games. But yeah, I'll show you guys the matchups and everything real quick. So here, the World Cup of Pokemon Round 2, we got East versus Germany. And look at this, PTC versus Mancy. Like, some people don't know anything about Mancy, got subbed in. Flamingtini versus Rillos, which is going to be really interesting, because I don't think people know much about these players that got subbed in for Team Germany. So I hope that I can catch US East off guard. TDK versus Obliv, like, a lot of people would say this is heavily in the favor of TDK, but I really hope that Obliv can pull this out. John versus ICT, this is so scary, man. I really hope that ICT can win, but I don't know how. And Get This Money versus PKC is like a highlight match for a lot of people. Get This Money went 3-0 in first round, and I think PKC played Gen 3. He wanted to play Aurath, and like not that many people from his team wanted to play Aurath, or no one. Like, he was the one that wanted to play Aurath the most, so they put him there. I hear a lot of people say this is heavily in favor of East, but... Maybe it's because I'm German, but I think Germany has a chance, like... Because, like, some of these players are not known at all, so they can, like, bring some surprise teams that you will never expect. Oh, Tsunami vs. X-Ray is gonna be... Oh, I don't know how good X-Ray is at DPP. I can't really talk about older gens. I know Jet vs. Blurry is gonna be a good one, too. I'm obviously gonna focus on these games, I guess. And yeah, we have Latin America vs. Europe, the score is 0-1 at the moment. There was a Gen 2 game earlier that I didn't record. There's like some really cool matchups. Dennis EG didn't play first round, Black Oblivion has been doing pretty well, he's 2-1. Ricardo 2-1 too. Pearl vs. Gondra is pretty high, but Pearl was 2-1 in first round, Gondra was 3-0. Alcanz vs. Thorn is a fire matchup. Oh, Porsche was doing pretty well. Latin America was... not in World Cup last year, and they had to play like a qualifying round, and now they made next round like a top 8, which is pretty impressive. France vs. US West, a lot of people think this is in France's favor, and the highlight match here would be probably the Sijumas vs. Kring. And yeah, like Sijumas has been doing so well, he's an upcoming star, if you would say so. I don't know if I should have said that word, but he's like upcoming GOAT. And my man Easy got subbed in, so I'm gonna be recording that if I can. He played one game in the first round, which was in Auras, and he won. But now he's playing Sun and Moon, so we will see what happens there. Like, these matchups are pretty, like, exciting to watch. And I mean, Dennis is gonna be rooting for Team Italy, they're playing versus Spain. And a lot of people say that Spain is the favorite to win this. And we get a rematch here, which is really cool. They played in the last round, Asuya Solwind took the timer win. Let's see if Solwind can strike back this time. Alexander vs. Poik is fire. Poik didn't do too well last round, but I'm pretty sure he's going to be motivated to do his best when his team is in playoffs. And Alexander went 3-0, which was pretty surprising. Like, no one really expected that. And there's also going to be a tiebreak for the 15th or 16th place. I think this determines which team... I think this determines which team has to play a qualifying round next year for World Cup, but I'm not 100% sure. And there's only 3 games, which is cool. I hope I can record analytics with Gypsy King. The thing is, he's from Oceania or like Australia or something like that. So like that, he might play like 5 a.m. my time because it's a different time zone. But yeah, I'll try to get these 2 Sun and Moon games for you guys if I'm gonna be able to. Thank you guys for watching. We will be back later. Most of these games are gonna be played on the weekend. And yeah, stay tuned for more content. I'm also gonna be doing some Showdown lives if you're into that. I did one with Lopunny earlier that I'm going to be uploading tomorrow, probably. I'm going to do one with Mega God, one with Mega Gallade. My boy T is going to do one with Gallade, probably. So stay tuned for that. Have an amazing day. Thank you guys for the support. And we will see you with more World Cup. And let's go Team Germany. Let's say it in German. I gotta think of something German. Wir holen uns den Pokal. Let's just say that. So if you're German, you understand what I'm saying. And goodbye.